Praise the Lord. Whenever she's back in praising the Lord, you know, I like to see people get back.
Amen.
I like to see them every once in a while raise those hands and begin to give God.
Amen.
I say this all the time, and I'm going to say it again tonight. We live for the Lord 7 days a week.
Amen.
Not you should be. We live for the Lord 7 days a week. But when you come into the house of worship, and this is a house of worship,
yes,
you should come in with a worship and a praise on your heart and on your mind.
Yes.
You should come in and say, God, I've come here tonight to give you praise for what? I praise you because you went to the cross.
Amen.
I praise you because one morning early, the stone was rolled back.
Amen.
And you came out. Hallelujah. Think about it today.
Yes.
If he'd have stayed in the grave, if he hadn't came out that day, that morning, if he hadn't came out, we wouldn't have been no better off today than where he was the day that he came out of the grave. But he came out. He came out. And because that he came out this morning, this afternoon, I thank God because he's a real God.
Amen.
Amen.
I thank God because I'm not serving something. You know, you can go to where they laid on Muhammad, and you'll see his bones. They'll be there.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You can go to the other people that have been worshipped, and they're nothing but a stone.
Right.
You can go to the place where they laid, where Joseph laid our Jesus Christ, and all you're going to find, hallelujah,
yes,
is an empty tomb.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You're not going to find him there. But if you want to find him, I'm going to tell you where you find him. Find you a place where you can get to the on the altar and begin to talk to God. And you know what you're going to do? You're going to come in contact with this man that I call Jesus Christ. You're going to begin to find him. And how you're going to find him, you're not going to see him walk up in here, but one of these days we will walk in the presence of God.
Amen.
One of these days I'll look up and I'll see my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And I will reach out a hand and I'll take hold of that nail scarred hand. Hallelujah.
Yes.
I feel the presence of the Lord. You're going to reach out and you're going to take a hold of that hand. And when you do, you know what? This old body that we live in today, we can take so much of the presence of God. Hallelujah. You can take so much of the blessings of God right here on this earth. But one of these days, I'm going to tell you right now, I'm going to stand in the presence of God and
amen,
I'm going to have a body.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I'm going to have a body. God's got for me, I'm going to stand there and exhort it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Do you love the Lord tonight?
Amen.
Amen.
Are you ready to meet him?
Amen.
Are you ready to say, Lord, I'm going to shake your hand?
Amen.
I love the Lord tonight. He means more to me than all of the world put together.
Amen.
You know, if I had the power, if I could take a pencil and write a check on the world, and I had that ability to do that tonight, I wouldn't trade it for what I feel.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. In my spirit. Hallelujah. What does it say? Even though we gain the whole world,
and you lose yourself,
what does it profit?
What does it profit?
Hallelujah. Naked, I came into this world, and naked, I'm going out.
Amen.
I'm going to have anything in here. When I leave here, I don't care if I'm the world. When I leave here, I'm going just the way I came in.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Faith is what it's going to take to get us from here to the portals of heaven.
Amen.
Believing that Jesus Christ died on that cross. Believing that he came and he done the things that he done on this earth. And believing that one of these days the trumpet's going to sound.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Gabriel, he's going to say, Gabriel, pick up the horn. Hallelujah. And I believe, you know, I tell people anymore, they say, do you ever not think about that? The signs of the coming of the Lord.
Nope.
I quit thinking about the times, about the signs of the coming of the Lord.
Sure.
I don't think about them anymore. You know what I do? I am looking for his coming.
Yes. Amen.
I am looking for his coming. I drive down the road sometimes, and I look up and I see a cloud that's a little different from the rest of the cloud. Have you ever done this?
Amen.
And you come out and I look and I see a cloud and I say, oh, what a day for the Lord. What a beautiful day for the Lord to come again. What a beautiful day for Him to take His children home.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I feel like I'm one of His.
Amen.
I know him.
Hallelujah. I'm a child of the King.
Yes.
You know what? We go around sometimes with our heads down and thinking, oh, everything is bad. Why could it be bad when you're a child of the King?
Amen.
He has everything. He holds the world in the palm of his hand.
Yes.
That's my Father.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's my Father. He has it all.
Yes.
And I'm his son.
Amen.
Yes. Hallelujah. I'm his son. I'm not going to hold my head down. I'm going to look up. I'm glad that I belong to the King.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Tonight, I want to speak to you. If you've got your Bible, you want to follow along with me, turn to the Hebrews, the 11th chapter. Hallelujah. And just stay with me. Hallelujah. I feel the anointing of the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. I feel like that we need to have a meeting in this place tonight.
Amen.
I feel like that God wants to bless His people. He wants to raise His people up. He wants them to know that He is God and that He wants to bless them, that He wants to be blessed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now this, I know everybody in this church has read this over and over and over so many times. Whenever that, I'm going to preach on it a little bit tonight. Hallelujah. It said, now faith. Now, right now. Faith that you need right now to get what it is that you need from God. How many times have you heard? You know, I've said this many times. There was a lady that used to come to the church here, and she, every day, she'd have the same prayer request. And she said, Brother Oscar, I have prayed and I prayed and I prayed about this situation. She said, I have prayed and nothing is happening. I said, well, why don't you just quit praying? She said, but it's not going to happen. I said, God heard you the first time that you prayed. Quit praying now and believe that God is going to do what it is that you want. Let your faith take over and begin to believe that He's going to do what it is that you need to get done.
Amen.
And whenever you do that, it wasn't long until that lady said, come in one morning and she said, you know what? God has answered my prayer. I said, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Now faith is the substance of things hoped for.
Amen.
The substance. What is it you're praying for? What is it you're praying for tonight? What is it tonight that you'd like to have? How many people that came and knelt into this altar tonight, that knelt down in front of this altar, when you came into this church and began to pray, there was a substance that was on your mind.
Amen.
There was something that was on your mind whenever you came in and you sat down, you knelt at this altar, there was something on your mind. There was substance, there was some substance on your mind that you needed from God or that you wanted God to move in some situation. Faith is a thing. This is faith. Now, faith is a substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. The evidence of things not seen. I'm going to go on to read.
Yes.
For by the elders obtained a good report. Through faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the Word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Hallelujah. But I'm going to tell you right now, that is as simple as it can possibly be. Hallelujah. That is understanding. Hallelujah. Believing that God is fixing to do what it is that you need done. By faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of this gift, of his gift. And by it, he being dead, yet speaketh again. Hallelujah. Cain done killed. Hallelujah. But he was speaking out. Hallelujah. By faith Enoch was translated that he should not see death, and was not found because God had translated him. For before his translation, he had his testimony that he pleased God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That he pleased God.
Amen.
Now this is the one I want to get to. Hallelujah. But without faith, it is impossible to please him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is.
Yes.
Did you hear that? Was that understandable, what I just read?
Amen.
You got to believe that God is before he's going to do anything for you. You got to believe that he is.
Amen.
And that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Those that are diligently seeking God.
Yes.
He's a rewarder of them that diligently seek him.
Yes.
You know what? How many people are you going to find in the world today that are diligently seeking God? How many people will you find today out there on the street, whenever you go out on the street and you begin to talk to people, and you begin to say, hey, everybody that you talk to, everybody's got a story. Everybody's got something that they want to talk about.
Amen.
Everybody in the world today, them that don't believe in God, they've got a story to tell. But let me tell you something. The Bible says we, as the ones that are of God, have an altar that we can go to that they do not have prayer. To it. We've got an altar that we can go to God, and we're believing that he is the believer and the one that will give us what it is that we need. We can go to him and talk to him. You know what he's going to do? If you believe that he is.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I've said this so many times. I'm going to tell this story again tonight. You know, whenever I was living at this house, and at the end of one of the hallways, there was a little closet there. I told this so many times, I feel like telling it again. You know, I began to go to that closet and begin to pray and begin to talk to God. And when I first went there, I mean, as I'd go into that little closet, I made me a little altar in there. And I'd go into that little closet, and I would sit down, and I would kneel down right before that little altar, and I'd begin to pray. And it wasn't long. It'd take, maybe sometimes it would take an hour till I begin to feel the presence of God, and that he began to move into that place. And I kept going back to that little closet over and over and over again. And it wasn't long till it was about 45 minutes when I began to pray to God. I began to feel the presence of God as he began to come into that little closet. And it wasn't long. I kept going back. I kept going back. And it wasn't long, but about 30 minutes, I began to pray, and I began to feel the presence of God when he began to come in. But the greatest day of my life was the day that I started walking down that little hallway, and I could feel the presence of God before I got to the place. I was looking for the Spirit of God to come into my life. Hallelujah. I love the Lord tonight.
Yes.
Amen.
The substance. What is it you need in your life tonight? What is it you need in your life tonight? The substance. What is it? Believe that God can take care of it. Yes. Believe that God can do it.
Amen.
And if you believe that God can do it, let me tell you something. There is nothing to stop it from happening. Nothing can stop your faith. Nothing can take the place of faith. If you believe it, if you need a healing,
amen.
Believe that God can do it. If you need something in your life, believe that God can do it.
Yes.
And you know what he's going to do? He's going to give you. He said, I am wanting to give my children what it is they need.
Amen.
Now that's a paraphrase.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We're his children.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
We are.
We're not, you know, I've heard some people say, you know, I just don't feel worthy.
Amen.
Have you given your heart to the Lord?
Mm-hmm.
Have you accepted him as your father?
Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Be worthy.
What's wrong? What's wrong? What's happened? What's taking place? I tell you what, God, the devil has come in, and he's trying to tell you, you don't have no faith.
That's right.
Hallelujah. How much do you believe in this man, Jesus Christ?
That's right.
with all that I got.
Then you're full of faith.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Then you're full of faith. Hallelujah. Faith is the substance of things hoped for. Faith. Hallelujah. If you believe in this man, Jesus Christ, you've got faith.
Amen.
You've got faith. But if you don't believe him, hallelujah, you're not going to get what you need from God. The Bible teaches me that it is impossible to please God without faith.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It's impossible to please him. I see people say, I watch so many times, and I go to other churches and places where I go, and I can see people sit, and I can tell you instantly whether they have any faith in their life or not.
Amen.
You know what I'm talking about. You can Amen. See people that are sitting there needing something from God, but they don't have enough faith to believe that God will give it to them.
Amen.
All we got to do is believe that God will give it, and all he said he was ready to give us what we need.
Yes.
He said, I will give you the desires of your heart.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
That is right.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
And we sit around right. and wonder why that we can't get a blessing.
That's right.
Amen. Bless the Lord.
Hallelujah. We sit around and wonder why can't I get my blessing like I need to. Do you believe in it? Hallelujah. Do you believe it? If you do not believe that there's a God, don't ask him for anything because he's not going to give it to you.
Amen.
But if you believe that God is God, and that Jesus Christ is the Son of God,
yes.
Let me tell you what. All you got to do is believe what it is that you asked him for, and he will give you that.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. I feel the presence of the Lord in this place tonight.
Amen.
I feel like that we need to begin to believe that God can move in ways that he's not moving right now.
Yes. Thank you.
Hallelujah. I remember when I was a kid, I was grown up, and I was brought up in a General Baptist church. Hallelujah. I was brought up in a General Baptist church. And I've seen them General Baptists laying out in the streets speaking in tongues. Hallelujah. I've seen them out there just speaking in tongues and laying in the streets speaking in tongues. They've lost their belief. Hallelujah. What's happened to the world today? We have no faith.
Amen.
Amen.
We don't have no faith. All we got to do, you know, I've seen people heal. I've seen people heal like you've never seen before. I know that God can do it. Every time that I see God heal somebody, you know what it does for me? It gives me more faith.
Yes.
The substance. The substance. What it is that you need. What God can do for you. Believing that he is the God that can do it.
Amen.
We're fighting a battle today.
Amen.
In this world. We're fighting the devil. We have an adversary that would like to take you apart.
Amen.
Understand? We have an adversary that would like to take you completely apart. He would like to... What did he come to kill? To steal?
And to rob. Destroy.
Yes.
How many families? Let me ask you a question about it. How many families have you seen the devil come in and told him to take that family and tear them completely?
Amen. Amen.
How many people, just think about it tonight, how many people look back in time just a little few years? How many people have you seen that used to be on fire for God?
Amen.
How many used to be on fire for God? Whenever you come to the church on Sunday night, they'd be the first one up to praise the Lord. And now today, they're out there in the world.
Amen. Amen.
They're out there in the world, and you try to talk to them about God, and they don't want to hear about it.
That's right.
Amen.
Why? Faith. The substance of things hopeful. Faith. Examine your faith tonight. Hallelujah. Examine your faith tonight. If you believe that Jesus can touch you, or if you believe that God can move in your life.
Amen.
Right.
There was a woman in the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
and had an issue of love.
Amen.
She had spent everything that she had, and she was not no better. Spent it all. She got down to where that she didn't have but one thing that she could do. Touch the hem of the garment.
Amen. Yes.
Yes.
Touch the hem of the garment. What did she say? If I could but touch the hem of the
garment.
I know that I would be made whole.
I know.
Yes.
I know. She didn't want no doubt in her mind. No doubt in her mind. She said, if I could but just touch the hem of the garment. Sometimes to touch the hem of the garment, we have to press through. We have to get everything like we need. We got to believe that when we get there, that God's fixing to move. Hallelujah. I thank the presence of the Lord. We got to believe that when we need to press through. And we have to touch something is fixing to take place. Hallelujah. I believe tonight. I believe with all my heart. I believe with all my heart that it's not going to be but a few years if I live a few years, if ye don't come back.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Oh, this is what is tearing me up. Hallelujah. I believe with all my heart I'm going to walk right up to him.
Watch his ears.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
I believe with all my heart that when I reach out to touch his hand, when he reaches that hand out with them scars in his hands,
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
I believe.
Thank you, Lord.
That I'm going to look at him. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
I want to see him for what he is.
Amen.
Amen.
He may be tall, he may be short, but he's my God.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. He may be a dark complexioned person, he may be white than that. Hallelujah. I believe I looked down at his feet. Hallelujah, I feel something coming on.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I look down at those feet and I see the metal prints in the top of his feet. I believe. I believe. Faith. It's what's going to get me here tonight, here to the portals of heaven.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Faith is what's going to get me from here to the portals of heaven. I believe that I'm going to be there. And as long as I keep that substance that I faith that I have for, that substance, you know what that substance is? It's standing before my Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Oh, yes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Bless
yes,
Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Bless
yes.
Him, Lord.
But without faith, he said it's impossible to please God.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Amen. I want to please him tonight.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I want to please him tonight. I want him to know that I believe he's the God of all gods.
Amen.
I want him to know that he's the God.
Amen.
That can deliver whenever we need deliverance. I want him to know that I praise him because he went to Calvary, because he died on that cross, because he shed every drop of blood, and because that he came out of that grave, that something called the third day, and he rose up into heaven. I thank God tonight. I want him to know I'm with him, and I have the faith to believe in him. Take me on.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Where's Shannon?
She's back there with the kids. Your song?
Have a great day. What is it you need from the Lord tonight? What is it you need from the Lord tonight? Right now is the time to get it.
Amen.
I'm going through a crisis in my life, and I don't know what to do about it. This man named Jesus, he said, I will take, he said, I'll take your burdens, bring them to me. How can we do it if we don't believe in him? How can we do it if we don't have faith to believe that he will do something with it?
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I feel the presence of God. I feel the anointing of the Holy Ghost in this place right now. Hallelujah. I feel the anointing of God in this building right now, from God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Believe it. He is real and he's God. Hallelujah. I know what you're going through, God. In the name of the Lord, right now, raise your hands to the Lord, God. Almighty God. Hallelujah. Almighty God, in the name of Jesus. God, this tormented spirit has got to go in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. It's got to go in the name of the Lord. God, we rebuke the spirit that's coming against him. God, in the name of Jesus. Why? Because we believe that you're God and that you can't move. Hallelujah. It's got to go. It has no other choice but to go. In the name of Jesus. God, move in church life right now. Starting right now, Lord. Hallelujah. Let that freedom come right now. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Believe. Believe, church. It's the devil. Believe. Believe that it's not fixing to happen again. Hallelujah. Here. Hallelujah. Believe, church. Believe in him. Believe in Jesus. He is moving away. He will move it away. Hallelujah. That's why he died on that cross. That you could be free. Hallelujah. In the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Is something else? Is there something else? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord's hands to the Lord. Thank you for what he's fixing to do. Hallelujah. Thank you right now for what he's fixing to do in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. God, we thank you because you're doing what you're doing in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you. Hallelujah. We thank you because you're doing what you're doing right now. God, the cleansing of the mind. The cleansing of the mind right now. In the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, yes, in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, Father, come up here in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, in the name of the Lord. Raise those hands to the Lord right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, right now, God. I want you to take this thing away from him. And God, give him a pure mind in the name of Jesus. Put your hand upon him, Lord. God, give him the victory that he needs in you right now in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. God is a delivering God. Hallelujah. He's one that'll move it whenever nobody else can move it. Whenever nobody else can do anything, God can move. Yes, in the name of the Lord, obey the Lord, worship God. Let Him know that you love Him and worship Him. You're in the house of worship. You're not out on the street in Chicago. You're in the house of the Lord.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Oh, Lord, my God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Tyler, you need the Holy Ghost in your life. You need the gift of the Holy Ghost in your life.
Hallelujah.
You need the gift in your life. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
You need God to move in your life. Hallelujah. Whenever God fills you with the Holy Ghost, you're going to have power.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. You're going to have something that you can fight the devil with. You know what? You
know what before.
The scripture says that the definition for power is
the
ability to act.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Yes,
you need the ability to act. Whenever you know on the day of Pentecost, they was running, they was hiding, they was going everywhere they could because they was afraid that somebody was going to cut their heads off or crucify them. They thought everything was going worse than they could ever dream of.
Thank you, Lord.
But Jesus told them, you go to that upper room and you tarry until you be, oh, hallelujah, until you be good for power. Come on, high.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You say, whenever they come out of that upper room that day, they had the ability to act. Hallelujah. They had the ability to act. They went out on the streets of Jerusalem and they began to tell them, you've crucified our Lord. You need to give your heart to God. And you know what? As they began to tell them what was going on and what they had done, the church was added to 3,000 souls that very day. Hallelujah.
We need that in our life. We need the gift of the Holy Ghost in our life.
Hallelujah. We need to give them the gift. You know, some people sing for the Holy Ghost. They cry. You know, I've done the same thing. I wanted the Holy Ghost in my life stronger than anything I could ever have. I mean, I stayed on that altar for 6 months. I said every time they give an altar call, brother, I was on that altar call. I was on that altar and I said, God, I'll do anything you want me to do. Just fill me with the Holy Ghost. I want you to fill it. You fill me up. I was out in Illinois in a little old church. It was a chicken house. And they swept the floors and said that. They swept the floors and made a little church out of it. You kneel down on the floor, and when you got up, you could see spots on your knees. Hallelujah. I was sitting back in the back of the church, and I said, oh God, I need the Holy Ghost in my life. And God spoke to me. He said, receive ye the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, you go to that altar, I'm giving it to you. I didn't get it. He said, receive it. I don't even know. You know what I done? I jumped up and found a little bench. I went to that altar, and my knees didn't hit that floor, and my hands didn't get up in the air until I began to speak in a language that I didn't know what it was about, and I never felt as close to heaven in all my life as I did that day.
Hallelujah.
I was still in school. I told you this a lot of times. I was still in the school at the time. I couldn't quit speaking in tongues. I'd go to school and I'd sit down in the class and the Spirit of God would come upon me. And when it come upon me, I'd start speaking in tongues. I'd walk down the hallway of that old school, and as I walked down the hallway of that old school, the Spirit of God would come up on me, and I'd begin to speak in tongues. I wanted everybody in that school out to have a gift of the Holy Ghost in their life. Hallelujah. One morning, as I was going into my homeroom class, Mr. Wilson stopped me at the door. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He just got me to the door. He said, Oscar, I don't know what your religion is. He said, I don't know how you believe. He said, we have no more of this. He said, you can't be doing that. But I thought, I can't help it. What I'm doing, I can't help it. I said, okay, Mr. Wilson, I'll do the best I can. I went back in that class, and I took the back seat in that class. Hallelujah. And I got to thinking about it. And I got to thinking what the deal that Jesus had done that I could have this spirit in me that I have. And I began to feel something begin to roll up inside me. Hallelujah. I took my arm and I laid my head down on the desk. And it wasn't but just a little minute that the Spirit of God began to come upon me. And brother, I've done what Mr. Wilson told me not to do. Hallelujah. I began to speak in that language again. And he just sat up there and looked at me and shook his head. Let me tell you something, my friend. That Holy Ghost today, he said it's for us today. It's for them that are far off. We're far off this morning. We're in that category. But the Holy Ghost is still for us today.
Amen.
Hallelujah. All we got to do is what? What did he say? He said, receive the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
I'm already giving it to you.
Yes.
All you got to do is take it and do what you can with it.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. God is a living God.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. The substance of things hope for. What do you want tonight? What do you want tonight? I want everything that God's got for me.
Amen.
I want everything that God can give me. I want it.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I want everything that He can put to me. I want it. Tyler, receive the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Receive it in the name of the Lord. Take those hands and raise them up to God. Don't bow your face down. Raise those hands up and give God praise. Begin to praise Him and God will fill you with the Holy Ghost. Don't bow your head down. You're not, you don't have to. You're a child of the King. You don't have to bow your head to nobody and especially anything that the devil would have for you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Tyler, begin to talk to him right now. Begin to tell him, I need the Holy Ghost power. I need that gift in my life. I need the ability to stand whenever the devil is coming at me. I need the ability to act. I need that power. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, Tyler. Begin to worship God. Begin to talk to him. Begin to talk to him. Hallelujah. Begin to talk to him. Tell him thank you for it. Thank you for it. And when he puts words in your mind that you don't understand,
amen,
don't worry about it. Just speak them. Hallelujah. Just speak them. They'll not be out of order. Hallelujah. Just speak them in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 In the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. God. In the name of the Lord.
Jesus.
God, fill Tyler right now with that Holy Ghost gift. Hallelujah. With that Holy Ghost gift right now. In the name of the Lord. Fill him with it right now. He needs it in his life. He's facing a world out there that it's just unreal. And God, he's facing things that I never dreamed of facing when I was in that. Hallelujah. God, touch him right now. Fill him with the Holy Ghost, God. Fill him with it right now. Fill him with that power. Give him that power that he needs. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah,
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Receive it. He's already gave it to you. Receive it. You don't have to beg the Lord for the gift of the Holy Ghost. All you got to do is receive it. Took me a long time to understand that.
Amen.
But one day,
amen,
he said, I have already given it to you.
Amen.
Just take it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank God that I've been filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost in my life. Hallelujah. I thank God, and I'm not ashamed of it, and I speak in tongues. I'm not ashamed for people to know that I am one of the most great Pentecost, the Holy Ghost people, that is speaking. And if God tells me to speak some language, I will do it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 God can fill you. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do you love the Lord tonight?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Have the faith. Keep the faith. Believe that He, you know what? Just like the Bible says, it's impossible to please God without faith.
Without faith.
You're not going to do it. But you need that faith in your life. You need to be able to believe that God can move in your life.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I hope you got something out of this tonight.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.